I'm going to talk here. Good evening, everybody. I'm Sally Sparks with the Keep Music Live Project. I'd like to welcome you to probably about our 16th concert that we've held online since we started doing this back in March. We're hosting artists from all over the planet, and I've got to turn my volume down. And Muriel's coming to us from Nashville tonight for the second time. She played with us one of our first shows a couple of weeks ago, or almost a month ago now, I think it might have been, where I think we're all kind of losing track of time. I wanted to let you know some of the other shows that we've got coming up. We've got the Irish traditional singer and guitarist John Doyle will also be back for a second show this coming Saturday afternoon at 3 p.m. Eastern time. That would be noon in California or 9 p.m. in Central Europe. And we have Mar, who lives locally here in Asheville, with a wonderful blend of singer-songwriter type music that you and Latin music. Mar is from Peru, and I think we'll have a sizable audience coming in from South America. Next Tuesday, we have Amici Music, which has been a Streamside favorite, Tuesday evening with Dan Weiser playing classical requests. If you send them in to amicimusic.org, classical piano solo. And then on the 9th, we have Max Hat and Etta Glass. It's a wonderful a blend that they do, very unique sound. They've been featured at the Lincoln Center, Kennedy Center, and on NPR. When we'll have them on May the 9th. And we keep going as we're all in isolation, finding ways to connect online with live music. So I'm really glad that Muriel wanted to come back and join us again. And I'm going to bring her online now, and we hope you enjoy the evening. Hope to see you again. Bye.
Well, it's wonderful to be here, and thank you all for all the requests that have been coming through. You know, it seems that from the tone of all the requests, I'm seeing today as a celebration of moving forward, and everything is on the upswing from this moment on. So let's kind of consider that. And so I thought a good one to start with would be Here Comes the Sun. And I'm here in my home, but behind me I have a screen, or rather it's a bed sheet that's pretending to be a screen. And Bryan has put together visuals for this because he's done a lot of work now as we've had requests coming in over the days. He's actually put together brand new videos.
He's a slave driver.
There's Bryan. And so this, we're going to have a lot of premieres here. Actually, you'll be the first to see some of these because I haven't even seen them yet. And so this is what he's putting behind Here Comes the Sun. Thank you. Oh, that's kind of fun. I like to improvise on that a little bit each time, so never know how it's gonna turn out. So that's what makes it fun for me too. In addition, just having a little flexibility and play with it. We had a request for a tune, really more for Bryan than for me. So did you happen to see the solar eclipse when that was through, the total eclipse? And it was really an amazing thing. And Bryan and I were there on the lawn of the Capitol building in Nashville. And it was one of those days, there were just a few clouds passing by. And Bryan had his eye on these clouds. And he calculated the speed of the clouds and the time of the eclipse. And all of a sudden, he grabbed his camera equipment. Well, everyone else who was there had flown in from all over the world. And me too. We just, you know, sat there. And it was just this incredible experience where the lights went out, and then the lights of the city went on as the sky got dark, and the crickets came out, and the stars came out. And then right at the moment of totality, that one cloud passed over the sun, and we missed that moment. But Bryan got it. He was just, Bryan, where were you exactly? That's right. He was out someplace, blocks and blocks away, and got actual video footage of that totality. So he's put together his images and my images, and I happen to have my harp guitar with me just to kind of pass the time. And it was then that people started requesting. They said, oh, play Moon Dance, play Moon Shadow. So all of a sudden, I became the accompaniment for this event. So I'll play some of the tunes that I was playing then, and Bryan will do a visual of a combination of what he saw and what I saw. And so this is our reenactment of the eclipse. Thank you. Change guitars now. Let's have a hand for Bryan. Yay! I'm going to be playing a guitar that's I haven't ever played in concert before, actually. So this is a very old guitar. It was built about the time I was born. Actually, that's not that old, is it? He's a young whippersnapper, isn't he? So this is going to have a little different sound from my other guitar, so I'm kind of discovering it as we go. And it's a flamenco guitar, old flamenco. But we had a couple of requests for tunes in the style of Tierra Negra. I'd recorded the New World Flamenco CD for them, together with them. And it was just a wonderful time. And they became a big inspiration. So this is a tune that was really inspired by Tierra Negra's playing, but it was also inspired by do you remember that story, The Old Man and the Sea, Ernest Hemingway? So I was trying to kind of capture that story, you know, in that style. So just a little recap, if you remember. So there was the old man was just feeling kind of glum. He wasn't catching any fish. And so he decided to go out sailing and went further and further until he caught the biggest fish of his life. And then there's this battle between man and fish. And then there's this battle between the man and the sharks who are trying to eat the fish. And so finally, when he pulls into his little port town in Cuba, he's trailing nothing but the skeleton of what was his fish. And I'll have Bryan just put the visuals behind just to kind of put you in the place. So this is, you know, in that place, and I'll have you kind of come up with your own images in your mind. So I call this one The Old Man and the Sea. Thank you. Well, I hope you saw some of the images in your mind's eye there. So that was for Paul and Len, who had requested that. And my good friend Herb Tanimoto had requested Two Shores. So that's a song that, again, I hadn't played for a while, so it was kind of fun to rediscover it. And we'll see what this guitar wants to do with that. Thank you. Well, Bob had requested that I play Lullaby for Leo, and that's a song that I haven't played for a long time for a couple of reasons. And it was written about something that not a lot of people write about. It was written about a real strong friendship, you know, a platonic, beautiful friendship, and friendship with the entire family. So it's kind of like a feeling like having a second family. And but I have played this sometimes with string quartet, where I can kind of hide behind the strings. But for some reason, with this song, it feels like it's revealing a little too much of my soul in this. You know, it feels like it's a little too personal. And so I kind of stopped playing it on stage. But it got requested, so I guess I have to play it. So, you know, that one isn't too hard to play. And sometimes when something is not as difficult to play, you can put a little more heart into it. And if you're one of my students on my new TrueFire site, I've got that wonderful new platform where I can teach privately and show lots of videos as well. You can go ahead and request that, and I'll teach it to you there. So that's that would be a nice one to do. All that information is all linked at murielanderson.com/now. So the link for my TrueFire page, or you can also find it if you go to quarantutor.com. That'll bring you right there as well. So either of those places will bring you there. So just thought about that. That would be a nice one to do. I haven't taught that one yet. I'd be happy to do that. Oh, I'm going to change guitars. Because we just had a request for Lady Pamela, actually both from Fred, and also as a special request to do this for Allison's birthday. So this is a birthday request. So, but it's down in a dadgad tuning. So, on a normal guitar, that would be D A D G A D. But this harp guitar is tuned up a step, so this is an E. It's sort of like an E-gad tuning. And that brings us there. This harp guitar has half-step tuners here in the basses, so some of them, the notes I can get a little quicker. This was written for Pamela. So this is also for Pamela. There's two Pamelas I'll do this for. It was written for Pamela, who sends out my emails for me. She's been a wonderful assistant and great friend over the years. So she wanted me to write a song for her, and I finally did. And this is it, Lady Pamela. So happy birthday, Allison. I hope you're having a great birthday week here. There's another song that was in this tuning that Herb had requested, and I had written this in Montauk, New York. So I'll do this one for Anne also. This is was written at her family's home. When we had built a beautiful sandcastle on the beach, and by the next day the waves had come and gone and left just this mound of what was our sandcastle. So we took that mound and built another sandcastle, even more spectacular than the first from it. So I got to thinking about that and how my friend was bemoaning the loss of his home and how that kind of reflected with a sandcastle. And it was coincidentally written just a few days before Hurricane Katrina. And so a lot of people had kind of felt a special affinity to it then. So this is called Castles in the Sand. Oh, yes. Yeah, we're getting some very lovely comments coming in. Well, yeah. So we'll maybe have Bryan share some of those after a little while. So this is Castles in the Sand. For all of our toil, all of our plans, castles are built in the sand. And after the storm, after the waves, together we'll build it again. It's not for the castle, not for the sand, not for the view from sea to land. It's for a smile that you can bring. It's just to build a beautiful thing. The hurricane came just in a day. The life that we knew washed away. I watched as my hopes disappeared in the sand until I saw one outstretched hand. It's not for the castle, not for the sand, not for the view from sea to land. It's for the people, the care you can bring. It's just to build a beautiful thing. As much as I've mourned possessions that passed, castles may not always last. Built for the process, not for forever. Built for the love we're building together. It's not for the castle, not for the sand, not for the view from sea to land. It's for the people, the care you can bring. To live is to build a beautiful thing. To live is to build a beautiful thing. Oh, thank you very much. Well, that is an appropriate song for many of us now. It, we have to stop and kind of reevaluate things. We have a couple of requests from Velzo's friends. Velzo Brown is a wonderful jazz pianist and trombone player. She played with an all-girl jazz band in the 20s. She was still playing gigs at 100 years old and was a great inspiration to many of us. And when I was on tour in Santa Cruz, where she lived, I went to visit her and jam on some tunes. And I asked her if she could do me a favor, if she would let me work in her garden, because when I was on tour, I really missed my garden, just really missed digging in the weeds and digging out weeds and that. And so she said, well, of course. And so she told me that she was going to put up a plaque saying, Muriel weeded here. So I was kind of inspired by her. And so I wrote this tune. And actually, her mutual friend Tracy wrote some beautiful lyrics to this. So I'd love to have her sing those someday. But it was written like this. So this is Velzo's Garden. Kind of inspired by a little children's nursery rhyme. And thank you. And those are photos courtesy of Carlton and also some of Steve Palazzo's photos of Velzo and of her garden. So great memories there. Well, Karen had requested a Baker's Dozen. Making me work here. This is one that's in 13/8 time. I'd written it after the Greek festival, annual Greek fest.
And are there tunes coming up that the guitar players listening might want to have their guitar?
Yes. Brian, that's a great thought. If you have a guitar handy, you might want to pull it out and get it in tune. Maybe there's something we can do together. Maybe we can write something together. We can, just improvise something together. You know, Phil Keggy and I used to do that all the time. We just get together and without any plan, just start playing and see what comes out. So, sure, we can do that remotely. Why not? All right, let me tune up a little bit because I have to get into that nice Greek tuning. So, inspired by Baklava. Actually, that's was part of how this book came about. This is the Acoustic Chef. It's a cookbook with a CD that goes with each recipe, music for each recipe. And the baklava that inspired this very tune is in there. So, makes me hungry. I think I'm going to make some of that right after this. Brian, what do you think about that? I think baklava tonight is on the menu. Here we go. This is a Baker's Dozen. Aha. Well, it actually has a really cool little super trebles part, but I forgot to do my treble string, so I improvised on that without the treble. So I'll have to do it for you again the next live stream and add the little super trebles here, because that's really a fun part. So I should make a note here. Tune, note to self, tune the trebles before playing. Okay. We have now a request from Jody coming in for a prayer without ceasing. Maybe I'll use that.
Maybe a hearty thank you to all those who have hit the tip jar so far.
Oh, we have some tip jars coming in. Thank you so much. Because, you know, in this time, this is how we're making a living now. An entire year of concerts have canceled. So this is it for us. And if you're struggling yourself, then this is fine. This is my gift to you. But if you can spare something, if you feel inspired, sure do appreciate a little contribution to the tip jar. And there's four different ways you can contribute. That's all at murielanderson.com. It's on the screen. Great. And you can just click there and appreciate, you know, any help. So. So Bryan said he found some images for this one. So I'll see what's going to be behind this. And so this is prayer without ceasing. Oh, some clouds. Great. That's a very special tune for me, because it wasn't ever meant to be recorded or performed. It's just that, you know, everyone knows it's a good thing to give a prayer of thanksgiving, just in general. Just pray for thanks. And I'm just not really that good at prayer. And so I just asked my guitar to do it for me. And so that's, I just, you know, sat down with my guitar and said, okay, prayer. And then that's what it played. So that's you know, very special. And so it was just written for me, and was doing some recording with Phil Keggy, and he asked me to write something that we could play together. And I came there, I said, I just, you know, didn't come up with anything that week. And he said, well, what about that little prayer you wrote for yourself? And so I said, okay. And so we played it, and he improvised some beautiful, beautiful things on it. And then ended up recording a full string section on it, and just turned into this an incredible piece on the Nightlight Daylight CD. And it happened to be in that studio. Here, I'll show you this. That's this one here. Beth Nielsen Chapman was in the studio that day, and she was inspired by this piece and wrote some lyrics for it. So on one, it's a double CD. So on one of the CDs, it's got the Prayer Without Ceasing, and then the other CD, she wrote lyrics for it, and it's done as a vocal called Pray. So this is I showed you this last time. This is the one that lights up when you push the moon. So that's the light up CD. But it was just a kind of a series of events that was inspired from the very beginning. Well, do you have your guitars out? What do you think about maybe writing something together? I'll do it on my regular, my young guitar. So, maybe we'll write a folk song. So by definition, folk songs are written by folks, so that's us. So we got it. And, well, if you have your guitar, let's see if my tuning is somewhat standard. It seems standard. Okay, tune with me. So we can just do with, maybe four chords or so. Maybe G, C, D, an E minor maybe. We might throw in another chord or two. We'll see. I'll call them out as we go. Start with G. So you can, start with just a little rotating bass or just bass strum, a little strum or... And let me see how... If you can do a little finger-picking pattern. That gives us kind of, the Pete Seeger kind of Joan Baez sound. Come with that bit. D chord. How about a C now? Back to D, G. Walk down to E minor. Back to C. D. Say, while we're doing this, if you're thinking of any lyrics, take out a pen and pencil and write down some lyrics. This doesn't have a title and it doesn't have any lyrics. Let me see if I can remember what I just did. We'll do it again so that you get a do it a few times so it kind of give you a feel. Gonna go to a D with a little F sharp in the bass. Now C, D, G, E minor, then C, D. How about C, G, back to C, E minor that time. G, walk down, E minor, now C, D, a little G, maybe walk down. Again time, C, D, see if we remember the beginning. Yeah, that's right. C now, D, G, E minor, C, D, C, C, E minor, C, G, walk down to E minor. C, up to D, that little walk down, again, G, C, D, back to the theme again, see if you can remember it. C. Oh, let's do that little ending in D to G. Very folksy. G. All right, if you have a idea for a title or any little bits of lyrics, you can go ahead and send those in. That'd be fun. And you know, this is folk music. You know, no country star is going to record this. Nobody's going to be making money off of this. This is just for fun. So just to share. So that didn't turn out too bad, right? So let's see. We're getting some. Let's see. The black one is the voice mic. Yeah. Want it a little louder on the voice mic? Okay. Oh, okay. All right, great. Oh, all right. We're getting some. Oh, we had a request for the Liberty Bell. All right. Okay. Let's do that then. I'll do it on this. Here we go. Liberty Bell.
Okay. Brian's going to pull up a visual for.
Oh, wait a minute. We should let you know that this was written by John Philip Sousa, who was my grandfather's boss. My grandfather played saxophone in John Philip Sousa's band, and that's why I learned it, try to imitate the sounds of the marching band instruments. And it was also the theme song for Monty Python's Flying Circus. Liberty Bell March, John Philip Sousa. We had two requests come in for The Immigrant, looks like now. So this is one that I'm also teaching on my True Fire channel. So
after this is all the chat stuff, so the guitar players should be.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay.
I don't know if they can hear me back here. But
yeah. So my great-grandparents on both sides of the family immigrated from Finland to the Massachusetts to work in the quarries there, to Cape Ann. And So I was thinking about this time and the challenges of this new country, but the promise is at the same time, and the memories of the old country. And that was the inspiration behind this. I call it The Immigrant. There we go. That was for Pat and Vivian, and actually a couple others who had requested that as well. Yes. Yeah, we have also a request for Mr. Chester. That's interesting. So that has a story behind it. Are you interested in the story at all? So Chet Atkins was a big influence, and I met him through his brother-in-law, who was my mandolin teacher at that time, Jethro Burns. And so I would go over and to his office, most of the time he'd give me a little guitar lesson, say, here's something you should learn, and he'd show it to me. So there were a lot of guitarists coming in and out of his office. And one day, and this is long before I was playing concerts, I was just playing in a hotel lobby at this time, and Chet came down the stairs and he said, Muriel, I've got a job for you. And so I was pretty excited. So I was thinking, oh man, maybe it's like the Grand Ole Opry or something like this. And he said, well, what it is my pet rooster, Hotshot, has come down with a case of the feather mites. And my wife and I are getting kind of old. And besides, we're just too big to crawl into that chicken coop. And he said, I was going to ask little Jimmy Dickens, but you just happened into the office. Oh, yeah. You're about the smallest person I know. And so that afternoon, I went over to the Atkins home for the first time. And then, sure enough, there were a little group of people had gathered around. And you have to crawl into that chicken coop, the little door, and then grab the rooster by both legs at once. And then your other hand, you grab his neck. And, you know, this is something new for a girl from Chicago just coming down to get a guitar lesson. But nevertheless, I got the rooster. And then Chet's wife, Leona, spread bacon grease around the rooster's neck for the mite dust to adhere to. And they dusted that. And then I caught the hen, whose name was also Leona. And afterward, Leona invited me to join them for lunch. I think it was chicken stew, coincidentally, no relation. But after that, I got thinking. I wrote this little tune. I call it Mr. Chester. Oh, yeah. And Brian's going to show some pictures from when I was very young. Of course, I didn't start playing quite that young, but we'll run those through while we're playing this. Thank you. yeah, that was the days. Actually, Bryan, I think it's the cable that goes into this little unit, the black cable that goes into this unit. It's kind of textured. That's the one you want to turn down. Yeah, not over there, over there. So, okay. Thank you for calling in and letting us know that. Okay, so this is the black textured cable with the lines. So this is, so, sorry, normally I like the sense of power to have the big microphone. So, but not that much. It's a little too much. So thank you for letting us know. Is that better? Sounding better? Okay, good. Oh, let's see. We had a request for a very special tune. I wrote this for Bryan, actually, when we were in the process of making the Nightlight Daylight CD. I'll show you this picture. We were doing it has two front covers, as you see, night and day. And this one, let me see if I can get this so you can see it a little better. Yeah. So this is the cover with the dandelions in it. And we spent a whole day finding just the right dandelions for this picture. And I'm the third child flying in the dandelion seed on this. And after spending this time together, I realized that I was starting to get a warm spot in my heart for Bryan, and I didn't know if I would see him again. And so I wrote this and actually recorded it on this CD before it was clear that we would see each other again. So this was a real raw emotion on that CD. I think that's what a lot of people are picking up. So it's hard to play it with quite that emotion now that, you know, that we're together. But so I got to thinking that there was another reason that dandelions were very special to me, because I remember when I was a little girl on May Day, I would make little paper baskets and fill them with dandelions, pick some dandelions, and then drop it at a lady's front door. So there was an older lady who lived by herself, and so I would just drop it there and then knock on the door and run away. And Bryan found some of these images. I took a picture of the very house where I did this. We're going to start with that picture, actually, on the images. And Bryan has put together this reenactment specially for today. So this is a very special premiere. I haven't even seen it. So this is Dandelions. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, that's thank you for requesting these tunes. It's really been this inspiration that's brought me back to doing these tunes again. So great to revisit those.
Brian Burns, you mentioned my birthday.
Oh, thank you, Brian. Oh, also, if you'd like to give Brian something for his work, please do. Yes, yes, please just mention that in the comments and say this is special for Brian. So, yes, he's done a lot of work for this, so I would like to definitely. Dandelions is on Nightlight Daylight, so that's... oh, wait a minute. We have a special code. All right. Don't tell Pam I told you this. This is, let's see. What's the special code? Oh, yeah. Let's see. I think it's on my website. Home. That's it. Okay. If you put in the code home, you get $5 off anything in the shop. I'm glad I remembered that. So as you're checking out in the shop, if you're picking up Nightlight Daylight or something, right at the end of the checkout thing, put in the word home, and you'll get a discount. Yes, thanks. I really, really appreciate the tip jars are coming in. We want to fill up the tip jar. So thanks so much. Any way that you can give, it's really, really appreciated at this time. We had requests for three different Spanish tunes, so I thought I would just put them together into a medley. And I'll play it on this guitar, this old flamenco guitar, just to see what it does, you know, give it a different sound. Thank you. we thank you so much for joining us here. We've got a few more requests. I think we can go over a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so we can do this. Yeah. So we've got a request for, see, a request coming in for Close to You. Okay. And Bryan's got some visuals for that, right? Okay, cool. Yeah. So this is one that I plan to teach and kind of break apart the whole arranging process on my True Fire channel. So we're going to be doing a live stream actually on May 7th. So it'll be a live stream that'll emphasize, you know, composition, arranging techniques, as well as performance. So it'll be both instructional and performance there. So that's be listed on my website, or it's on murielanderson.com/now. That's where all the current stuff is listed. It was fun to arrange, just to try to capture the piano player and Karen Carpenter's voice, you know, freeform singing over it. And this is what I came up with for Close to You. Thank you. All right. So were you singing along there? Okay. I know some of you were singing there. I could hear you over the waves, over the cosmic waves. We could hear.
Request for Sakura on harp guitar.
Oh, I've never played Sakura on harp guitar. So, I don't think so. Not on this one. Sakura, no.
Oh, then
we can save the harp guitar for why we're. Well, I mean, I could possibly do it.
One more harp guitar song coming up after Sakura.
Oh, after Sakura, okay. All right, so this is Sakura Cherry Blossom. And, thank you. Domo arigato. Thank you. I just try to capture a little bit of that beautiful Japanese spirit in that, and a little bit of that flavor. So, we have a request for Why Worry. So maybe we'll just do one or two more for today. Harp guitar. Harp guitar, okay.
So, play
and
sing NOLA.
Oh, you know, I have to work that out because I can't sing it in the key that I play it in. NOLA, yeah. So we had a request for playing and singing NOLA. Okay, so that will be for the next time, see if I can do it. The thing is, I'd have to transpose it to a different key to sing it. So, but it can be done, right? So we'll see when we can revisit this. You can stay in touch via my website. Drop me an email, my top secret email address, Muriel at murielanderson.com. Yes. And you can also find out if you subscribe to my channel. That's the True Fire channel. You can go to quarantutor.com, or the links are also at murielanderson.com/now. So all those links are there. And this time I am going to tune my super trebles to the right notes for Why Worry. And sure appreciate you stopping by and spending this time with me. Makes me feel like, you know, the world is coming back around, and it's a great place to be. So, a perfect song for this. Oh, yeah. Yes, we are also giving away 7 days free on that channel. So that's a special thing for this week. And I have that link. It might be linked here. And if not, it's on the screen. Great.
They don't need a credit card.
Yeah. You don't need a credit card or anything to log in. It's just to try it out and to learn some things and have some fun on that channel. So you can, join me there. We were even talking about doing a, more regular little mini live streams, maybe on Monday nights or something like that. So let's open up that conversation, see if we can do that. Here we go. This is Why Worry. Thank you. Oh, that is our theme for the day, is why worry? And especially when we're looking at a day sailing in Brian's sailboat. You took all that in one day, right, Brian? Out sailing, yeah.
I just stretched into a week, but
yes, well, thank you again for joining us. And I want to thank Sally Sparks for making this possible. It's really a great, great service for all of us musicians, what she's doing here with the Keep Music Live project. So I'd like you to support that and check out some of the other acts and other musicians that she's promoting there. So it's wonderful. And even with the help of Fretboard Journal and Dream Guitars to help promote it, and they've been just great and helping out as well. So much appreciated. And one last request. Let's see. That one went out to John and Dan, among others. And Mario and Millie had asked for View from Space. So let's see. It's on there, I think. Yeah. Just the last minute they asked for it, and Brian doesn't even know it's there. It should be. Okay, so we'll leave you with this, and thank you very much. We so appreciate your contributions as well, and then.
And this will be archived.
Yes, this will be archived as well, so you can come back and visit it again. So if you register, don't worry, the archive link will be sent right to you. If not, I'll put it up at the murielanderson.com/now, so you can find that either place. So we'll leave you with this View from Space. Thank you. Have a wonderful night, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you all.
Thank you from Bryan and myself. Much appreciated. Hope to see you again soon. Yes. And I'll put on the headphones so I can hear from Sally. Yeah.
You're still live, so you may
as well
talk about the channel a bit.
Oh, yeah. That's right. If you're still listening, yeah.